Okay, we're gonna call this introducing a horse to a new pasture. Of course, Buddy was sleeping until he heard me talking. I'm gonna beat him if he comes over here. So you're gonna see him get beat. All right, he heard me say I was gonna beat him. Oh, he's gonna get beat. Come on over, Buddy, get beat. All right, so he's relaxing. Mr. T relaxing behind him there. You can tell by their little legs. Oh no, Rick, that's not true. I heard if a horse cocks his leg like that, he's gonna kick. That horse ain't kicking nobody. Mr. T just straightened his little leg out. All right, here's this email I got from a girl. Now this is, and I talk about this a lot. Every question I get, the answer is it depends. There's really no right answers, and the people that are asking questions about horses looking for easy answers just show that they don't understand the depth of their question or what they're asking or where they're coming from. So, if I can read this question here on this girl. I recently adopted a horse who was in a stall the majority of the day because she was a racehorse. Well, go figure. They knew she had never been out of the stall for long. When transitioning her horses from a barn that kept her in a stall for 15 hours a day to another barn where I was going to want her in pasture all the time, what is the best way for her system to transition from grazing very much to from not grazing very much to grazing all day? Thanks. Okay, now you could probably ask 50 people this question and probably you get 50 different answers, and everybody that gave you an answer probably wouldn't give you what I would consider a good answer. Because it would be like, oh, she'll be okay, or oh, just do it for an hour or so a day, or just, you know, there'd be a lot of variations. But to me, if you understand horses and you understand the slow way is the fast way, you would know I'm not going to throw a horse that's never grazed out to a rich green pasture and let him graze all day. Now, would I throw him in a dirt paddock with a little grass? Would I throw him out in a pasture where the grass was cut down and there wasn't much there and they could just nibble? Sure. Would I throw them out in a nice big hay field that was just about to be cut and fully grown hay where they could eat and gorge themselves to death? No. So, you know, this question, I'm just kind of like, okay, obviously you haven't watched very many videos. This is what I call a poor question, like most questions are, because it never gives me enough information and I can always ask 1,000 questions. So instead of playing 1,000 questions, I just wrote her back. It depends. Tell me what your concerns are, what factors you think you should consider, and then I'll tell you what I think. So I'm giving her a hint to think this out. I want her to think for herself. I want her to try and realize and find her own answer and not wait for me to email. You know, by this time the horse is either going to be in a stall for a week or it's going to be out dead in pasture because she's letting it gorge in a rich pasture. So a day or so later she writes back. I had noticed on one of your videos discussing supplements and vitamins and food for horses part one that their systems can get shocked. That's good that she noticed that. I'm glad. From not being used to grazing. She was very underweight, but is looking much better since they rescued her from a kill barn about 2 months ago. My biggest concern is overloading her system when she isn't used to eating all day. Well, she kind of answered her own question. I don't know what the hell she's doing right to me or what she wants me to tell her. You're right, don't overload the system. You're right, you don't want to shock the system. You've already told me that. What exactly are you looking from me? What exactly are you looking from anybody? You're the horse owner, it's your responsibility. You're the one, but he's wandering around, he's beside himself. He's been looking for a place to lay down and roll for 20 minutes and he's just frustrated that he can't find him a nice spot that he likes. So now he's gonna chew on his branch here and tear up a tree. Horse tear up a railroad track with a rubber hammer. All right. So, when you ask a question, you need to realize you can answer your own question. I mean, I don't mind being a resource, and I don't mind getting you in the right direction. I don't mind helping you if I don't address it in a video, and it's not on my website. But because I've been doing this for several years, and because I put everything, every question I get, pretty much I either answer it in a video or on my website. If you read those two areas, buddy, you're getting a beating. I'm beating you like a stepchild. What the? Oh, I'm killing you. Get your nose out of there. Oh, you are, buddy, I'm gonna, that's right, I hit my horse. So he's beside himself. Now he's gonna go pick on poor Mr. T. He's over there trying to relax. Kick his butt, Mr. T. Alright. So this lady answered her own question, people. Well, you don't want to shock the system. You know a horse's system. And when I say it's sensitive, it's not so sensitive that you're going to kill them if you let them go out there and graze. But you can cause them a colic. You can give them a bellyache. It could be a severe bellyache. Could be an easy bellyache. It could be grass they're not used to. It could be too rich. Could be too dry. They may not like the water. They may not drink. Is it green? Is it dried grass? Is there dirt? Is it the kind of grass for horses? Or is it some other grass that's just weeds and junk? I mean, there's so many questions that I could ask when somebody asks me a question. I'm like, you know what? You can't even ask a question and give me enough information to give you a reasonable answer, because if you knew what to ask, then you wouldn't need to ask me. You wouldn't need to ask anybody. And that's what I want. I mean, as much as people think I want to just kind of crack on people and be mean, I don't. I don't even want to deal with people. That's why it's just easier to do these videos, and hopefully people that want to learn will let their horses get help. But you need to educate yourself. And if there's something you can't find on my website, well, that's fine. But if you ask me a question, I know it's on the website, I'm probably not going to answer you. I'm just going to delete it. And I pretty much delete most of the questions anyway, because I just get tired of it. You know, Buddy's got a blonde tail. Buddy's got 4 feet, 2 ears, 2 eyes. Okay? Tanner's brown. He's a Mustang. I don't know. I get more stupid questions about the horse, you know. What's your horse's temperature? Is Buddy's temperature different than Tanner's? What kind of rasp do you use? What kind of hoof pick do you use? What? Come on, people. Look, this is about advancing your horsemanship and understanding your horse and growing and becoming a better horse owner for your horse, so your horse can have a better life. And when your horse has a better life, believe it or not, you got a better life. I mean, it makes your life easier when you feel safe, secure, you understand a horse, you're not surprised, you're not guessing, you're not always worried, you're not always wondering out of the 20 pieces of advice you got, who's right and who's wrong. It just makes it easier when you know it yourself, you're self-sufficient, you don't have to depend on somebody, you don't have to depend on me, a website, video, nothing. You understand a horse and how they think, how they see, how they reason, what their abilities are, how they're reactionary, how they're prey. By understanding all that, then you should be able to answer your own questions. Now, since the topic of this is how to transition a horse from a stall to a pasture, it depends. Depends on the pasture. What I would probably do to be safe is I would put the horse, if it's already being used in a stall, I would keep it in a stall and I'd give it an hour or two a day, maybe in the morning an hour or two, maybe in the afternoon an hour or two, maybe 3 times a day. I'll give it an hour in the morning, an hour at noon, and an hour at night. And then I'll move that up to an hour and a half or 2 hours at morning, and 2 hours in the afternoon, 2 hours. And it's not going to take that long. If you just do it over a few days or a week, the horse is going to be fine. The horse would probably be fine if you just threw him out there. He would probably be fine, but there's more of a chance. And to me, I'm not willing to take that chance. I'd rather do it the slow way is the fast way with horses. When you try to take a shortcut, an easy way, you get yourself and your horse into trouble. The fast and easy way is to throw the horse out there and say he's a horse, and if he's too stupid to not eat himself to death, then he deserves to die. Well, that's the fast, easy, stupid human way. But the responsible horsemanship way is, you know what? I'm going to take the time it takes because I know it'll take less time. It's going to save me money in vet bills. It's going to save me money in stress. It's going to save me money in worrying about it. I'll just take the time it takes, and it'll take less time. I'll do it 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour at night, then go to an hour and a half in the morning, 1 hour and a half at night, then 2 hours, then 3 hours. Next thing you know, the horse is out there all day. His system's adjusted. He knows he's going to be out there. He's less likely to gorge. He doesn't think he's only going to be fed once or twice. He doesn't think, oh my God, I'm out in pasture. I better eat everything I can because I know some stupid human's going to come lock me up and put me in that stupid stall. If he learns that he gets out there every day in a routine, coming in and out a few hours, that's going to be fine. So I didn't even answer this question, lady back. I'm gonna tell her to refer to this video, and she'll probably be upset and want to tell me about how all she did was ask a simple question and all I had to do was give her a simple answer. The simple answer is learn and do what you think is reasonable, protect your horse, and become better. That's your simple answer, all right? When I ask you a question, I expected you to think about it, research it, figure out, and then maybe just figure it out. By now, you've already done what you're going to do anyway. You've wasted my time, but at least you let me have somebody to crack on so I can make a video, and then maybe somebody else will learn from your intelligent, thorough question. E equals MC squared. All right. Hope that helps. Bunny, you're a pretty good old boy. I'm glad you decided to calm down now. Mr. T, good boy. And that there on whatever it was, transition a horse from stall to pasture.